In this video, we'll discuss about digestion of food. The digestion of food initiated from the buccal cavity and after that in the stomach and also small intestine. So, major part of digestion will be happened in the small intestine. So, it starts from buccal cavity. First, we see the buccal cavity. In buccal cavity, there are two important processes. One is facilitation, second one is mastication. Facilitation and mastication of food. Here in the buccal cavity, the digestive juice is called the salivary juice. Salivary juice is mixed with food, that is facilitation. After mixing of this juice, that is called bolus. This bolus is passed through that pharynx to esophagus. That is called deglutition. The bolus now move to esophagus to stomach. Esophagus to stomach, that is peristalsis movement. Peristaltic movement. So, these are the steps in the buccal cavity. So, with salivary juice. So, we know that salivary juice have important composition, that is starch, amylase and lysozyme. The role of starch, amylase and lysozyme we will see now. First one is starch amylase. Starch amylase, which helps to break down 30% of starch. Next one, lysozyme. Lysozyme, which helps to kill the bacteria. So, these are the role of buccal cavity, salivary juice. Next one, here in the buccal cavity, the food which is mixed with salivary juice, that is called bolus. Now, the second one, in the stomach. In the stomach, what happened? Now, the bolus enter into stomach. We know that stomach also secrete juice, that is called gastric juice. The gastric juice mix with bolus. Stomach also has peristaltic movements because it is having gastric rugae. And here in the stomach, majority partially digested proteins. So that means in buccal what happened? Partially digested carbohydrates. Partially digested carbohydrates and partially digested proteins in the stomach region. The gastric juice, we know that the gastric juice are having mainly pepsinogen. So here, important composition of gastric juice, pepsinogen and prorenin. So, the prorenin very important in the infants, those who are mother feeding the milk. So, it will be digested. And here, it is digested by pepsinogen. We'll see now one by one. So, I said infants carry the feeding the milk. That milk which is composed with the protein substance that is called casein. Casein will be partially digested by the help of prorenin. This prorenin help the digestion of casein into calcium para caseinate. Now this calcium para caseinate is break down into prorenin helps to break down the casein, which is the infants which intake of mother milk. The mother milk is composed with the protein that is called casein. The casein is break down by the help of prorenin, that is break down into para caseinate. Now pepsinogen is the role, key role. It will be break down this para caseinate into calcium para caseinate. This calcium para caseinate will be continue as a breakdown as a disaccharide peptides, because I said in the stomach gastric juice will be partially digested protein. Partially digestion means it is the second phase of the protein will break down into peptides by the help of prorenin. The prorenin which is present only in the infant's gastric juice, but this is absent in the adult. In the adult, pepsinogen is present. That pepsinogen now break down the proteins, break down into proteases by the help of pepsinogen. These proteases will be break down into peptides. So these are the end product of in the stomach digestion. So these are the two things, buccal cavity and stomach. I hope you understand this digestion of food topic, the buccal cavity and stomach. In the next video, we'll discuss about small intestine.